We've been talking about the election results. Obviously, a lot of attention, deservedly so, getting played out in the close, razor-thin margins right now in the race for the presidency. But Aikiko, I know you've been looking at a couple other ballot measures here as well in regards to what issues Americans are finally getting their chance to weigh in on.
Yeah, particularly in tech, you know, we were so focused on Prop 22 over in California that would classify Uber and Lyft as well as other app-based drivers as independent contractors. But there are a number of issues that were on the ballot on the issue of data privacy as well as facial recognition that I think is worth noting, because it does feel like we're starting to see significant pushback against tech as well as just the privacy issue. Let's start with Prop 24 out in California. This is the expansion of the data privacy law on the books there, CCPA, that was passed in 2018, of course, that gave consumers in California a right to know what information companies were collecting online and then getting that deleted. Well, now that Prop 24 has passed, that means that this CCPA law that was already on the books gets pushed back, expands even further. We're talking about a tripling of fines for companies that violate the privacy of kids, break laws on collection of their information. We're also talking about an establishment of a dedicated enforcement agency, a state agency that would enforce this law, $10 million annual budget to do so. So that certainly would be a significant pushback for the likes of Facebook, Google in this state. There's another initiative that is in Portland, Maine. So not one that we often look at, but that had to do with facial recognition, banning the use of facial recognition by police as well as city agencies. And the new measure there, adding penalties on that, $1,000 that can be collected by those who have been found to be tracked by police and city agencies. So an interesting movement there, and potentially could be pointing to a larger shift that's happening against tech as a whole. Zach, I know you've been tracking sort of the broader picture as well in the election, particularly that question that was been raised a lot among voters, which is, which matters more? Is it the economy or is it the coronavirus?
Yeah, that's the biggest issue here. And as we've been discussing today, it's hard to tease those out because obviously, as we've heard from Fed Chair Jerome Powell, they're inextricably linked. When we think about where the recovery goes from here, you can't necessarily have a full strong recovery to get back to where we were pre-pandemic without businesses being able to reopen the way they want to. And you can't have that without cases going down. It was top of mind for Biden voters rather out there in terms of the morning consult exit polls that we saw play out. But about 3 in 5 Trump voters said the same in terms of COVID-19 and controlling it being very important. They stressed more the economic issues and recovery being much more important to them. But interesting that dichotomy, since they're so linked right now in this recovery.